Oh crap! Oh wow! Okay, the game hadn't even loaded in yet, and of course I have a little friend here who wants to play with me. Crap! Okay. Yes, yes. Oh, the only thing I don't like when I'm fighting animals is when they make that sound. Oh crap! Oh! Well, we got him. Only two arrows. Okay. Oh man, there was that dog. Yep, okay, well, we found him. So, well, hello everyone, and welcome back to Animalica. That was a little bit of a stressful entry here. Okay, well, yep, we are right outside Nova Base here, so let's just see. I'm pretty sure we're gonna run into more baddies in here, and yeah. I'm trying to see. Ooh, the balloon is right over there, which is actually my main destination right now because I want to go and place down my storage somewhere. I have 67 arrows. The only thing is I don't really have a... we have an axe and a stone axe, or a pickaxe and a stone axe, but it's not really weapons, right? So can I actually craft anything in the sense of melee weapons? We can make a bone club, which does 2 damage. Okay. I don't think it's gonna do much, but let's have one. Then we have it. We could make a wooden bow, but I'd rather wait until I get a crossbow. Well, we have this one already. We have the compound bow, but I prefer having 2 bows. So I have one that always have the normal arrows and one that always have the trank arrows. So I don't have to switch via this, but I can just press 1 or 2 depending on what I want to do. We did get a crowbar, so we can pick up some stuff. This is what you need to pick up structures or things like the storages and things. We do have a revolver. And 64 bullets. Might be good to have this. I don't usually use the revolver at all, but at this point in the game, it might be a really good idea to have one. There we go. Since we don't have that many arrows, I prefer the arrows in general to use a bow. But, okay, well, let's look around. There's a nice little farmhouse over there. Oh, look, a barn. I still see someone right there. Can I sneak up and take this green leaf? Anyone else? Oh, more arrows. Definitely want those. Okay, so let's try to deal with you. You're not dead yet. I thought you would be dead. Okay, well, you are now. Oh, let's make sure to get some arrows back before we loot this dude. There we go. And this one. And loot you. Nice. And remember to do a little quick save here. So, there we go. Yes, okay. But you never know what's gonna happen, so it's nice to be able to load an old save. I do make normal saves in between every episode here because I do like to make regular saves just so you have at least 3 saves usually in my save menu, so I can kind of go back if something happens, if I run into a bug or, you know, make some serious mistake or something, then I can usually load an older save. These are new too, aren't they? I don't remember seeing any with like these red berries. Ooh, I hope we can place these down ourselves. Oh, look at that. There's a little deer over there. I don't really want to chase it, though. I think it's a deer. Yeah. I don't really want to chase it because I might chase it into some baddies. So let's not try and do that. But I would like to clear out all the bad stuff here before we do anything. Otherwise, I might arrive with the balloon when I come back here, and then someone might have wandered right up close to us. Let's remove this. Got you. Got you. Oh my dear, what has happened to this person over here? I don't know if I want to know. What on Am I gonna run into a creature that has like giant claws or something like that? I don't hope not. Okay, we have one guy over there, we have one guy here. There's some contaminant over near that deer though, so I kind of like to go and save it. Oh, where did he go? He's hiding behind a tree. Okay, here we go. And ooh, let's try and run backwards here. Bill. And one more. Nice. Got you. Okay, let's get our arrows back if we can. Nice. Doo-doo. Okay, let's deal with you over here while I remember where you are. Okay. Oh, I think I hit him. Aha, nice. Nice. There we go. We're doing okay. And we still have, oh, I have 86 arrows. Oh, there's one more there. Let's pick that up. Mm-hmm. And there we go. I feel like it used to be that sometimes the arrows would break. I think they have a sort of durability or something. But eventually they will break, which means you don't always get all of them back when you're looting, you know, when you're checking a corpse and looting them. Oh, nice. Let's get some timber from this. There's a lovely little pond going on here. That's very nice. Can I get these? No, they're part of the pond. Okay. Okay, so we can take the balloon now, but let's... Oh, yes. By using an air balloon, you can travel to different locations of the world. The air balloons are marked with an orange marker on the radar. Well, we are going to look around a little bit, but let's just... Oh. Oh, we have to walk into it. Haha. Nowhere is a small Mediterranean. Oh, this is new. It's a new menu. Nowhere is a small Mediterranean archipelago and newest Animalica refuge. Its location was kept secret for years, but recently more servants somehow managed to locate it. Cool. And then we can travel too. And you can see it's a moderate threat environment. So we have the land base, which was the original starting area. Situated on a small island in the Black Sea, the land base is an old Animalica refuge. The terrain is mostly uneven and hilly, but contains some large flat areas to use for building. Oh, cool. I'm liking this new menu. That's pretty cool. And I love the info here. So we have Corpse Harbor, with its location kept secret. Corpse Harbor is the main trading hub in the game, composed of gently rolling hills and flat valleys. Corpse Harbor contains numerous animal types and rich resources. And yes, this is definitely a good place to go fairly early in the game, as it is a trading hub, right? So we have Kitsune's Den. Is a hidden Japanese village. Legends say that it was the home of two shinobi clans, both responsible for guarding the entrance to the legendary Dragon's Cave. Oh, I'm loving this. I love all this kind of story stuff. That's so cool. Akali Desert, situated somewhere in the Middle East. The Akali Desert is a semi-arid biome. The mountains and hills surround valleys, which contain numerous villages and scattered adobe houses. This location is rich in desert resources, and various desert animals can be found here. And it also gives you a little bit of an idea of what you're going to find compared to before when you only had this little picture. It would still kind of, you know, it is a desert, so that would kind of indicate some things. And you can see here it kind of looks kind of Japanese and stuff. But it is really a nice addition, I think, with this. Green Hills is a small East European island located very close to the first Animalica refuge. It has beautiful and scenic locations with rolling hills, birch trees, and colorful flowers. Numerous farms, various herds, and secluded huts can also be found here. Yeah, there's actually quite a few little POIs to find in this one. And the same in Amber Hills, there's actually a lot to find here. Once a great tourist attraction for its medieval feel, the highest point in Amber Hills are now a refuge for a handful of survivors, now reformed as fishermen and farmers. The island's terrain is composed of hills, mountains, and fertile valleys with an extensive coastline. And as you could see there, there's also something to watch out for when you go there. Then we have Dambar. Located in Central Africa, Dambar is a vast savanna where a large number of wild African animals can be still found alive. Dambar is also rich in mineral and ore resources. Oh yes, there's so many animals. This is a place where you really need to stock up on triangulars before you go here, especially if you want to, save every single animal, which I usually go for. I want to, save them all. If you're only going for one of each or two of each, like a male and a female, then you don't need as many. But I think most people actually try to save all of them. Red Mountains, situated in North America and composed of rugged banded snow-capped mountains and hills, sheltering long valleys, deep secluded canyons, and hidden cul-de-sacs. Red Mountains is a land filled with diverse resources and North American animals. Then we have Slice Land. It's a small Pacific island, and just like Aleria, and oh, that's the name of the new island that I couldn't remember the name of. And Apache is a special location constructed to provide a safe and friendly environment for base building, enrichment, and animal placement. And as you can see also, it has a little green marker up here. Then we have Apache is a small island located somewhere in Eastern Europe, and just like Slice Land and Aleria, is a special location constructed to provide a safe and friendly environment for base building, enrichment, and animal placements. It consists of a large area of flat land bordered by hills and water. It's actually a really pretty area, and you do have a couple of houses that you can use for, well, storages and decorate and whatever. Kairos is a land of sweeping hills and undulating valleys. The coastlines are rough and abounding with various bays, inlets, and secluded beaches. Numerous buildings and small settlements lie scattered about the land, as do animals and enemies. Just like Corpse Harbor, the exact location on the world map is unknown. Snow Ridge Heights. Located somewhere in the northwestern portion of North America, Snow Ridge Heights is a very rugged mountainous location permanently covered in snow. The central point is an ice-covered lake surrounded by a number of steep slopes, hills, and mountains, with a few passes leading into the higher elevations and beyond. Oh wow, we actually have, well, I knew this, but going through them like this, it feels like there's so much, but there is. It takes a long time if you want to explore everything in the game and collect all the animals and collect everything that you can collect. Located somewhere in the southwestern portion of North America, Dorado is another arid biome. In this desolate land, rugged and filled with hills and ravines, small herds of horses are still running wild. Burning Sands. Situated in North Africa, Burning Sands is a large hot desert. Although resources are limited in variety, it can be a rich environment for an avid explorer. Located somewhere in East Central Europe, Eagle's Nest is a very rugged mountainous area, permanently covered in snow. The towering mountains and tree-clad valleys offer some of the most scenic and beautiful views. That is very true. Okay, so Carlsberg. Once a small city, Carlsberg is now an abandoned ruin, conquered by nature. The biome is arguably the richest as far as diversity and quantity of many of the items available, especially materials, which kind of makes sense. It's a city, right? And you can see it's a highly dangerous environment. So definitely not where you would start out with going until you have, some proper gear and weapons and lots of ammo and stuff. Same goes for Pestilentia. Once a lush jungle, Pestilentia is now a desolate land completely overpowered by disease corruption. Yeah, this is an interesting one. Very creepy looking. I actually really like that there's this huge variety in scenery in the game. Aleria is a small Mediterranean island, and just like Slice Land and Apache, is a special location constructed to provide a safe and friendly blah blah blah. A rugged coastline surrounds the island that can be rich in aquatic resources. Ooh, nice. So even though it's for building, it sounds like we'll still be able to find some stuff out in the water. I love this building. Ooh, nice. Okay, so then we have Oceania left, which is a new highly dangerous environment. These two are the two new biomes they have recently added. Oceania is a small island located somewhere in the Pacific Ocean and used as secret base for the new world government. Heavily guarded by special forces, this location serves as a meeting place for scientists from all five fortress cities. Ooh, definitely a place we're gonna go and check out. But yeah, let's get some better armor and stuff first, and let's just check around a little bit here before we go anywhere. But I think Illyria is gonna be my destination in this time around for a place to settle down. So let's remove you. There we go. I know that was kind of a lot of reading, guys, but I thought it would be kind of nice to check it out since it is new that they have all that information. And also for anyone who's kind of new to the game, you can see how big it actually is. So there we go. Fortunately, we had some dead animals. Oh, look at this. That's so pretty. Nice. We have an enrichment. I don't know if there's anything in here. And I have a kitty who's meowing in the background. Sorry about that. He always does that. Right. There's a window. Yep. Okay. So, and these we can actually build ourselves. So there's this one, but you can also build some of these for your own animals. Or you can live here, of course, if you want to. Let's get this. And, oh, nice. Field identification. Okay, I'm sure there's someone else here that I'm gonna have to fight off. I think we can loot all of these, but let's just try and look around and see if we can clear out all the dangers around here. And then I will be coming back to loot everything a little bit more properly. Ooh, man, I wonder what happened here. Oh, but look at this. That's really nice. Yep, there's some goodies here we can get. We're gonna come back for it. We're gonna come back for it, guys. Let's just try and clear this place out. I think there might be someone over here. So, remove that. Oh, yep, there's someone right there. Okay, let's see if we can get him. Might be a little too far away. It doesn't turn red, the crosshair. Oh, but it did now. There we go. And oh, no. Oh, come on. There we go. Got him. Awesome. Oh. Keep kicking the bodies. I'm not a very nice person, am I? First I kill them and then I'm like kicking them around. Okay, so we got you. Do this. Oh, there's another trap right there. Let's actually, oh, let's take you and clear this out. There might be more traps in the area. We're just gonna have to keep a lookout for them. But let's clear you so we don't get ourselves, because you can, they don't usually do that much damage, but if you're kind of running away from something that has damaged you quite a lot, it might be that one thing that is gonna take you out. So yeah, I prefer clearing them when I see them. There we go. Medicinal plants. And not sure if there are any more baddies around here to deal with. Probably are out there somewhere, but let's just focus on this. Oh, there's some kind of house in the back there. Nice. Oh, lots of goodies to find here. Okay, well, let's see what we can find. And we have this big dome over there that you could use to plant some trees or something in. Anyone home? Okay, by using the medical bay in a laboratory, you can treat any of the animals you have captured. After the animal has been cured and tamed, you can place it in his enclosure. Yes. So you do actually have access to some stuff here, because you have a chemistry table. You can make one of these yourself, so you can make cures and taming potions, which you need for curing animals, tranquilizer to make more tranquilizer arrows, and there's a mutagen. I don't know if they've added anything new to what you can use this for, but it used to be used to make some special plants you could place down for decoration. Then we can make these fancy syringes, antiseptic, med kits and stuff in here. But of course it's kind of handy that you have access to it here. Okay, we can't loot any of that. Nope. I don't plan on... Ooh, nice, empty vials. I don't plan on taming a lot of animals right off the bat, though, because I usually want to kind of get settled, do some exploring and stuff, and then eventually I'm going to start building, and then I start taming my animals. So kind of build up supplies first, so I'm not really that worried about not having this at my own base, but I can make one of these eventually. And it's not going to be that far, because you can just take the teleport, right, to go back here. There's another one there, just wanted to check. There's no one out here? Nope. Okay. March 3rd, 2026. Memo from Mark to Patrick. Running low on Tranquiline Animal Tranquilizer. I looked into it, and there's no possibility of getting any more Tranquiline Animal Tranquilizer. The company is out of business, we need some other solution. I had the lab analyze a bit of the product, and I think the lab has come up with a recipe for something very similar, using plants that already grow in the area. It's a complicated formula, and it takes a lot of ingredients, but we tested it, and it works on the local seagulls. You'll have to do the final testing and get the dosage figured out, but it's supposed to work just like Tranquiline, so there's not too much risk of overdose. We have no antidote, but the Tranquiline antidote may work. I've included Scarlett's instructions on how to update your chem prep machine with the new recipe, and then all you need are the plants. These are the 5 plants you need to make the animal tranquilizer. Okay, so we need a couple of mushrooms, these 2, dog rose, cannabis, and snakeweed. I'll be coming by in a month, so I'll be able to see the recipe in action when I get there. Good luck with the plant hunting. Aha! Very nice. Okay, do we have any other ones here? Okay, then we have the medical bay, which is where you would be taming all your animals. As you can see, I already have some cures and some taming potions, but of course I need to have the actual animal. So, what did I pick up? You can see there are many animals. Okay, rabbits. Yep, I have a gray European hare, so I could just cure it in here. Just like this. There we go. And then we should have... See, it's blue. This is yellow. At least we still need to... They're infected and they're wild. This one is now tamed and cured and may... a male gray, so we can put this down. I don't want to put it down here, but I can do that back at base. Did I loot this? I probably did. Okay, I didn't loot it. Miss any more lore items? Did I? Is there anything in here? Nope. Okay. Well, let's check out the other building. And there's all these bottled bodies. Oh yeah, and if you are planning on settling down here, and when you start out, after a certain time in Nova, it's not in the game, you have to actually be in this biome, but after a certain time has passed, then these bodies will start disappearing, so they'll just, you know, kind of disappear on you, fade away. So you don't have to worry about that, because I have seen people who are like, oh, but then I have all these bodies lying around, which is not very nice. But as far as I know, they should disappear when a certain time has passed in this biome. So if you just play around here for a while, start setting up base and stuff, then they should eventually be gone. Let's see what we have here. Nothing on the beds. Oh, there we go. Nice, some more bullets, nothing here. Hi Patrick, I'm happy to report that Sliceland is clean. We cleared out the nasties and torched the fungus, nothing bad is left, and we've been all over the island several times. Sliceland is ready for habitation. We hate to leave the place, the weather is great, there are wide open vistas, good grassland and water, it's nice and flat, a perfect building site. We left the shed alone, we cleaned it up a bit, but didn't fix anything. It still lacks a door and windows, but it's quite livable in that warm climate. We're heading home and should be back by Wednesday the 5th. Regards, Ari. Here's some photos, you can see how nice Sliceland is. Yep. There we go. So that's one of the areas, of course, where you can choose to settle down and where you won't have to deal with any kind of baddies. Let's see, we checked this one. We haven't checked this one yet, right? So... Let's see. Oh man. There's really been some kind of fight here. Nope, nothing. Okay. 14th of December 2023. Dear Gregory, yes, by all means come here. Scarlett will handle all the details since she runs the lab along with everything else. We're lucky to have her. You'd never know by looking at her, but she's infected like all the rest of the field biologists. You'll only get a couple feet of lab bench and the equipment is heavily used, but we are doing amazing things here and we can really use your expertise. Best regards, Sandhya. Okay, got another one. Dear sirs, I'm writing you this letter today to offer what I can in support of your endeavor. When I heard about Animalica and its bold plan to save every animal on Earth from Dr. Moore's virus, I knew I had to do something to help. All my money doesn't buy much these days, so the only thing I can give of value is our family home, Apache. I have enclosed a bill of sale and a deed to our family's private island, Apache, located at GPS coordinates XXX something. It is free of contamination, but the last caretaker left a few weeks ago and there is no one there to take care of it. There is still livestock on the island, but there is good grazing and fresh water. It is flat, open range and free of danger. Apache is a good place to relax or a place to house animals, and I'm sure you will find a good use for it. There's already a house and a barn on the island for you to use. The land is flat and good to build on. My late husband's family has owned Apache for almost 100 years, and I wanted to be sure it went to good hands. I know my husband would approve of my gift. Before his death, he made many donations to support wildlife and the environment, and I can think of no better legacy than to see the family estate used for the betterment of all life on Earth. I thank you from the bottom of my heart for everything you're doing, and I hope Apache will be helpful to your endeavor. Sincerely, Mrs. C. R. Popescu. Ooh, that's very nice. Uh-huh. Well, I think I'm gonna start out with Illyria, but eventually I would probably maybe build a base like in all of them, you know, or at least settle down with animals in all of them, because if you have a lot of buildings and animals in just one area, like if you fill out one of those islands, it's gonna be really hard for your computer to run, unless you have like a monster of a computer. So yeah, but that was it for today, guys. We kind of finished looking around here, so well, this main little area, there's still lots and lots of stuff to do, and we do have to explore this entire island, right? But we're going to continue with this next time, so thank you for watching, and as always, do take care, and happy gaming!